of things to learn and places to go. So faith is the world in which we live. It has so much to give, so much to give. So great is the world in which we live. It has so much to give, so much to give.
Looking beautiful. Yes. Wow.
Sandy, what are you going to do with this paper and pencil?
I will write down everything that Vayu and Maya will show us, so that tomorrow in school, I can tell about it to all my friends.
Very good, Sandy. Children, we should always share our knowledge with our friends and other people, because by sharing, we always increase our knowledge.
I will also share my knowledge with my friends.
Yes, we will.
That's very nice.
Hey, what is this coming towards us?
What is this?
This is an aeroplane. Do you know, kids, what is an aeroplane?
Kids, this is a man-made flying machine. It's an amazing thing because aeroplane joins the whole world. We can travel from one place to another place in it. An aeroplane flies very high up in the sky, over the mountains, over the sea. Traveling by aeroplane takes less time, so we can travel all over the world in few hours.
The aeroplane is so big.
Yes, children. The aeroplane is made very big so that many people can travel in it at one time.
Who flies it?
Two pilots fly the aeroplane. The aeroplane has two large wings, just like birds. These two wings help the aeroplane to fly. Look there, children, the aeroplane has landed.
Children, the place where aeroplanes land and take off is called an airport.
Wow!
There are so many aeroplanes here.
Yes, many aeroplanes from all over the world land and take off from this airport. See, children, some aeroplanes have landed and some are ready to take off.
So aeroplanes are used for traveling long distance in short time?
Correct. We can also travel by train. Kids, look there. It is a train. It is so long and it has many compartments. Do you know, kids, at a time thousands of people can travel by a train?
More than an aeroplane?
Yes.
Wow!
Train is also a good way of transportation. Children, just as an aeroplane flies in air, a train runs on railway track. See there, we call that railway track. These railway tracks are spread all over our country and join every part of our huge country.
There are places where people can't go by airplane, but they can reach that place by trains. So children, trains play a very important part in our daily lives. It takes thousands of people from one part of our country to another part. That is why railways are also known as the lifeline of our country.
Kids, we call that a railway station. Just as aeroplanes land at airports, the train stops at railway stations. Children, there are different trains to take us to different places all across the country. So whenever we want to travel by train, we come to the railway station nearest to us. And when our train arrives, we get onto it. After the train reaches the place we want it to go, it stops at the platform so that we can all get down. So you see, children, the railway tracks link one station to another.
Kids, have you ever seen a bus? Look there. This is the bus. We use bus to travel shorter distances. It's not so long like a train. Around 40 or 50 persons can travel by bus at a time. The bus runs on a road. The person who drives the bus is called the driver. And the person from whom we buy tickets in the bus is called the conductor. Children, do you know every bus has a bus number and the name of the place where it is going? So we know in which bus we have to travel to reach the place we want to go.
Have seen, kids, airports are made for aeroplanes and railway stations are made for trains. Similarly, bus stops are made for buses. There is a long distance between two railway stations, but bus stops are made at shorter distance. The buses stop at these bus stops so that passengers can board or get down from the bus. These buses run inside the city and connect various places in the city. There are buses for long distance travel also. We call them tourist bus. These buses take us from one state to another state.
There is a red light. No, it's yellow. But it was red.
Hey, now it has become green.
What is it? And why does it keep changing its color?
Kids, this is a traffic signal. It has three lights: red, yellow, and green. These are not just lights. These are signals for the people who are driving on the road. Let's see what does each signal denote. The first light on the top is red. When the traffic signal shows the red light, it means all vehicles should stop to allow the vehicles from other direction to pass. The second light from the top is yellow. When the yellow light comes on, it means that the signal is going to change to red, so we should slow down our vehicles. And the last light from the top is green. When the green light comes on, it means that we can drive ahead. Children, traffic signals are made for our safety and we should always follow the rules of the traffic signal to avoid accidents. Even if we are getting late, we should not break the rules or else we can get hurt.
Red on top, green below. Red means stop, green means go. Yellow means wait, even if you're late.
Kids, look there. Can you see those thick white lines on the road? We call it zebra crossing. Zebra crossing has been made for people who are walking on the road. It's for their safety.
But these are only lines. How can these lines provide us safety?
Yes, these are only lines, but these lines are very important. Children, whenever we have to cross a road, we should always use the zebra crossing. There is also a signal across the zebra crossing that tells us when it is safe for us to cross the road. If the signal shows the man standing, then we should also stop. When the signal shows a man walking, then it tells that we should also cross the road. Children, it is dangerous to cross the road with so many vehicles traveling. So we should always use the zebra crossing and wait for the right signal to cross the road.
But this time it has got a plus shape.
No, Molly, this is not a red signal. This is a red cross sign. And this building is a hospital.
Children, hospital plays an important part in our lives. Whenever we fall ill, our parents take us to the hospital. There is a doctor in the hospital who does our checkup and gives us medicine so that we get well soon. Children, look there. Can you see the cross on that small house? It's called a clinic. It's like a small hospital. Every clinic has one or few doctors. The doctors in the clinic can only cure few diseases or small illness. If someone falls very ill, then he has to be taken to a hospital where he can be treated properly. See, children, this is a big hospital. So there are many doctors and nurses who cure the patients from all types of illness and injury.
Hey, look! There is a bus also with the cross sign.
No, dear. It is not a bus. It is an ambulance. See there? Along with the red cross sign, there is also a light on top of the ambulance. Do you know, kids, what is the importance of an ambulance? When there is an emergency, and the person has to be taken to the hospital immediately, we can quickly call a hospital and ask them for an ambulance. And the ambulance arrives very soon. Children, when an ambulance is running on the road, the light on top of the ambulance starts rotating and the ambulance gives out a loud siren as it moves ahead.
Why does it do that?
So that the other vehicles on the road know that an ambulance is carrying a patient who needs to reach the hospital at the earliest. All the other vehicles then give way to the ambulance to help it reach the hospital as soon as possible. So next time you are traveling by road, keep your eyes and ears open and you can surely see an ambulance.
Hey, where is that bell sound coming from?
Look there, children. It's a fire brigade's bell voice.
What is a fire brigade?
Fire brigade is a team of firefighters who travel on this vehicle. When there is a fire in any building or anywhere else that we cannot control, then we should immediately call the fire brigade. The fire brigade arrives as soon as possible and the firefighters put off the fire. In this way, they save our lives and our property from the fire. Children, just like an ambulance gives out a siren, the fire brigade has a bell attached on the top and a firefighter keeps ringing the bell. Can anyone tell me why do they do that?
So that the other vehicles give way to the fire brigade. And they can reach the place and stop the fire.
Very good.
Hey, children! Wow! Look there! Isn't it a lovely place?
Yes, we know this place. This is a garden and we all play here.
Yes, you are right. This is a garden. Look carefully, children. It has got so many trees and flowers. People come here to sit and relax under the shades of the trees and lie down on the soft grass. They all enjoy the cool breeze that blows here. Kids, do you know? Many people come here early in the morning to do exercise. In the evening, parents come with the small children. And children love to play in the garden.
Hey kids, look there. And I'm sure you know this place.
Yes, it is our school. We all
use it to study. Yes, it's a school. Okay kids, can anyone tell me why our school is important in our lives?
Our teachers teach us in the school.
They love us and tell us so many interesting things.
Just like you and Maya. School is very important in our life.
Yes, you're right. It's a place of learning, the knowledge that every child must acquire. In order to be actively disciplined is the difference between good and bad. And teachers in our school tell us what is good and what is bad in order to help us grow into a good human being.
Now kids, see here, this is a marketplace. A market is always a busy place because there are so many shops. Shops from where we purchase things that we use daily, like vegetables, clothes, shoes. In fact, we can buy each and everything that we use in our life from the market. Yes, Budo. Even ice cream too.
Look at that red box. Do you know, children, what we call it? We call it a post box. Whenever we write a letter to our relatives or our friends, we post it in a post box. And then a postman collects these letters from the post box and takes it to the post office. And this is the post office. The postman collects all the letters from different post boxes and comes here. And then from here, all the letters are sent to our relatives or friends across the country. Do you know, kids, that we can also send greetings, parcels or gifts to our relatives or friends by post?
Now see this place. Can anyone answer what we call this place?
Hey, there are so many people eating here.
Yes, children. Very good. It is a place where people come to eat. We call it a restaurant. In the restaurant, there are waiters who serve us and cooks who cook whatever eatables we order. The restaurants serve us eatables as well as our favorite cold drinks and ice cream.
Now kids, look at this place. Do you know what we call this place? We call it a police station. When a person does something wrong like stealing or robbing or any other sin and tries to hurt others, then a policeman arrests him and locks him in the jail here at the police station. So children, nobody should do anything to harm others. Or else, do you know what will happen?
A policeman will arrest us and lock us in the jail.
Thank you. Look at this place.
There are many animals and birds as they were at the farmhouse.
But why are they in cages? At farmhouse, they were not in cages.
Yes, because they were all domestic animals. But here, all these animals are wild animals. They can harm us, so they are kept in cages. And the place where we keep wild animals and birds is called a zoo. In a zoo, we see all types of birds and animals from around the world. By visiting a zoo, we get to know about various animals, birds and snakes that live on our planet.
Now look at that building, children.
It's a bank.
Yes. Bank. Bank is a place where we deposit our valuable items like money and jewelries. To deposit the money in the bank, we have to open an account with the bank. In this way, we and the bank know how much money we have deposited. We deposit money in the bank because the bank gives us interest on the money we deposit there. It means that when we put our money in the bank, it grows. So, whenever we have more money, we go to the nearest bank and deposit it in our account. And when we are in need of the money, we can withdraw a part of it from our deposit. So you see, children, there are so many things around us that make our lives simple.
Wow! I can't wait to tell about all these things to my friends at school.
Yes, tomorrow I will tell about this to all my friends. They all will be surprised.
We all will tell our friends about the city and how many interesting places we have in our city.
Good. I think we should go back. It's getting late now.
Yes, the sun is setting and it will be dark soon. Hello, kids.
So, what are you kids doing today?
Shaisha has drawn a hall of her house.
But it is empty and she doesn't know what to put in the house.
That's easy. Let me show you what we all have in our house and then she can fill her empty house with all those things.
And you will also come to know about the things around us in our house.
Hey, that will be very interesting.
So let me show you the first object in our house. Children, look what we have here. It's a television set. Kids, do you know what a television does? That's right, it entertains us. We all watch our favorite programs and cartoon shows on the television. We also get to know what is happening around the world in the daily news that is telecast on the television. And hey, look what do we have here? This is a remote control of this television. With this remote control, we can change channels and select one as per our choice and then watch our favorite shows on the television.
Wow!
Now what do we have here? Is it an almirah?
Yes!
No? This is a fridge. You have seen the fridge in your house, haven't you? Do you know what a fridge does? It helps keep all our foods and our tasty, tasty drinks cool so that they last for days without spoiling. This is how the fridge looks from the inside. The upper portion is where we can make ice. And what do we do with ice? We put it in our juice and enjoy it.
Hey, look! What is this? This looks like a TV, doesn't it? But this is not a TV. Do you know what this is? It is called a computer. Yes! Many of us have computers in our house. Let's see what we can do with the computer. Do you know, kids? This small computer has a very big memory. We can write lots of letters and store lots and lots of information in the computer and get it back when we want it. Yes, and we can store all the things written in our books in this small computer. Isn't it interesting? Okay, see children, this is the keyboard of the computer. On the keyboard, we have alphabets and numbers arranged in a particular manner. We use the keyboard to type various things. This is the screen of the computer. Whatever we type on the keyboard, we can see it on the screen of the computer. Do you know, children, the screen of the computer is also called the monitor. Now this is what we call the mouse of the computer. By moving the mouse and clicking on it, we can select different sections on the monitor of the computer.
Okay.
Isn't that wonderful? And now let me show you something else. This is a printer. Printer is something that prints. When we connect this printer to this computer, then we can print anything from the computer to a paper with the help of this printer.
Now look at this. This is what we call a bulb. We have many bulbs in our house. In fact, every room has a bulb. And the bulb is connected to the switch. Now children, what happens when we put on the switch? Come on, let's see. The bulb glows and fills the whole room with its light. Hey children, do you remember during festivals we decorate our house with colorful bulbs that makes our house look even more beautiful?
What we have here? This is a wall clock. And what does a wall clock tell us? It tells us the time of the day. The clock tells us the time to get up, the time to go to school, time to study, time to play, and time to go off to sleep. The wall clock comes in different shapes and sizes. And kids, do you know what we call the watch that we wear on our hand? We call it a wrist watch. This is how the wrist watch looks.
I didn't know that.
Hey, look, what is here? It has got numbers written all over. Do you know what it is? It's a calendar. Just as a clock tells us the time of the day, a calendar tells us the date, the day, the month, and the year. Look here, every page has the day and the date of a month. The calendar shows us the months to study and the months when we have vacations. So by looking at the calendar, we can tell the date, day, month, and the year.
That's really interesting.
Hey, look, what do we have here? It's a washing machine. What is it? A washing machine. And what does a washing machine do? It helps our mama wash and clean our dirty clothes. Isn't it great, kids? Did you ever think that a machine can clean your dirty clothes? But it is possible. Do you know how it is done? Okay, you put water and detergent into the machine and then put your dirty clothes into it and shut the door of the washing machine. Then you put on the washing machine and the machine inside starts cleaning your clothes. And when they come out, the clothes are clean and fresh. Isn't it wonderful?
Hey, what's this cute little thing that we've got here? It's a radio. Just as in television we can see our favorite programs, in radio we can hear our favorite songs by tuning the radio to our favorite radio station.
Look, children, this is a gas stove. And our mummy cooks delicious food for us on this gas stove. See, it has two burners and one cylinder. Children should not go near the gas stove or play with it. It can be dangerous.
I didn't know that.
Look here, that's a telephone. We use telephone to talk to our friends and relatives who stay far away. Every telephone has a different number. So whenever we want to talk to our friend or relative, we dial the number and we can talk to them sitting in our home. Telephone has saved us so much time that we can do other interesting things in our life.
Look, children, what have we here? This is called a mobile phone. Nowadays, people are using more of mobile phone because we can carry these mobile phones wherever we go. Like the other telephone, there is no wire attached to it. Isn't it interesting?
Yes!
Look there, that's a fan, you see. See, it has got three hands. When we put on the switch, the fan starts rotating in circle and we get cool air. We also can control the speed of the fan and thus control the air coming from the fan.
Children, there is one more thing that gives us cool air. That is air conditioner or AC. Look, this is how an AC looks. If we keep the AC on for a long time, then it makes our room very cool, just like the inside of a fridge.
That's really wonderful.
Children, look here. What do we have here? It's a nice bed. We sleep on a soft, soft bed after a hard day's work and play. Look, children, the bed has four legs. Let's see what else we have in this room that has four legs.
Hey, look, it's a chair. It also has four legs. What is the chair used for? The chair is used by us for sitting. Now let's look what else we have that has four legs.
What do we call this object? We call it a table. The table also has got four legs. We can keep various things on the table. We also use table and chair to have our food and also to study.
Hey children, look! What's this small thing we have here? Let me give you a hint. We use this to click pictures. So, can you now tell me what is it? Yes, it is a camera. Mummy and Daddy use camera to click our pictures. You must have seen your cute pictures in your house. The pictures along with your parents and friends celebrating.
Wow!
Hey kids, look what we have here. It's an iron. See the shape of the iron. Isn't it interesting? Do you know, kids? We can use this iron only when we connect it with electricity using the long wire that is attached to the iron like a tail. Now, what do we use this iron for? We use this iron to press our clothes. Yes, when we connect this iron to the electricity, the iron becomes hot and then we can press our clothes with the hot iron so that our clothes look neat, and when we wear the clothes, we'll look smart.
Hey, look! What do we have here? This is an envelope. Can you see what a wonderful shape this envelope has? The envelope is just like a pocket that we have on our shirts. What do we use the envelopes for? We use envelopes to send letters to our friends and relatives all over the world. We have big envelopes for big letters and small envelopes for small letters. Look around your house. You can surely find an envelope in which you or your parents must have received a letter or a greeting card.
Come here, kids. See what we have got here. It's a mirror. When we look into the mirror, we can see ourselves in the mirror. Yes? Isn't that great, children? Do you also know that in the mirror, our left becomes right and our right becomes left?
I didn't know that.
Look yourself into the mirror and you can find this out for yourself. Now, what do we do with the mirror? As you know, we can see ourselves into the mirror. So we use mirror to see our clean white teeth, to comb our hair and to see how smart we look.
Kids, here we have a lock. You must have seen whenever you go out with your parents, your mama always puts a lock on the door of the house. We also put our valuable items in a cupboard and lock it from outside. Locking our valuable things keeps it safe. So, the lock acts as a watchman for us. Now children, do you know how do we close and open a lock? We do that with the help of a key. And this is how a key looks. Now, do you know kids, every lock has its own key that cannot be opened with any other key. Isn't that great? Now, how do we open a lock with the key? We put the key into the lock and when we turn it to the right, the lock opens. And when we press the lock and turn the key to the left, the lock gets closed or locked. So, isn't it easy to use lock and key, children?
And hey kids, see what we've got over here. Well, we call this a scissor. Can you see the two sharp and long teeth of the scissors? The sharp teeth of the scissors are used to cut various things like clothes, papers. When you visit your barber shop, the barber also uses scissors to cut your hair. But they're smaller in size. So we have scissors in various sizes. And children like to cut their favorite cartoon heroes from various magazines and newspapers and store them.
Talking about newspaper reminds me that newspaper plays an important role in our lives. Let's see what the newspaper looks like. Here we have. This is a newspaper. It has so many pages. The newspaper man daily delivers the newspaper in our house. How is the newspaper important to us? The newspaper gives us news of what's happening around the world. It also has interesting articles and photographs of various important people and places from around the world. In this way, with the help of newspapers, we are always in touch with the outer world.
That's really wonderful.
Look children, here are few books. Just like newspaper, books are also very important in our lives. It is said that books are man's best friend. They are also children's best friend. A good book teaches us lots of good things about various things. In schools, our teachers also use books to teach us interesting things on various interesting subjects. Do you know, children, by reading good books, we become smart and intelligent? So, children, we all should make it a habit to read good books every day.
Hey, kids. Look what we have here. We call this a soap. Now, when do we use a soap? When we take our daily bath. Soap helps us clean our body so that after having a bath, we appear fresh. We also wash our hands with soap before and after every meal. This keeps our hands free from germs so that we remain healthy and happy all day long.
Hey kids, look what we have here. This is a bag. When our mummy goes to the market, she carries a bag with her to bring various things from the market. When we go to school, we carry our books in our school bag. A bag makes it easy for us to carry many things at one time, like many things from the market and our many books that we carry in our school bag.
Wow!
Now children, let's look over here. This is an electronic item and we call this a calculator. Now what does a calculator do? It helps us do simple mathematical calculations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division by simply pressing the correct buttons. Using a calculator is so simple, even you can learn to use it. So children, did you all see the interesting things that are there in our house?
Yes!
Children, these are the things that make our lives easy and simple.
Now whenever we see these objects again, we will know its uses in our lives.
Thank you, Vayu. Thank you, Maya.
But you may take this little calf. She will grow up to be a fine cow and feed you and your family well.
I was going to sell her for 12 silver coins.
The Brahmin was very happy with the buy.